Now, what does this question say? It says, find the values of P and Q if x minus 1 and x plus 2 are factors of the given polynomial 2x cube plus px squared plus qx minus 14. Since it is given that these two linear polynomials are factors of this polynomial, so from factors theorem, first let us assume px is, since p and q are already there, let's take it as fx. 2x cube plus px square plus qx minus 14. Now, since x minus 1 and x plus 2 are factors of px, fx, therefore, what do you get when you substitute this to 0? X equal to 1. So, f1 and what do you get here? You get x equal to minus 2. So, f of minus 2 will be equal to 0. What do we get? Since there are two unknowns, p and q are two unknowns that we have to find. So, we need two equations. So, one equation can be obtained by equating f1 to 0 and the second equation can be obtained by equating f of minus 2 to 0. So, what do we get? F of 1 will be 2 into 1 cube is 1 plus p into 1 square is p plus q minus 14 is 0. So, this would imply that p plus q is equal to 12. That's the first equation. And the second is minus 2 cube is minus 8. So, minus 8 into 2 is minus 16 plus 4p minus 2q minus 14 is equal to 0, which implies, what do we get here? We get 4p minus 2q is equal to 30, divided by 2 on both sides. So, we get 2p minus q is equal to 15. If you add equations 1 and 2, you will get q will cancel out and you get 3p is equal to 27. Therefore, p is equal to 9. And from 1, 9 plus q is equal to 12. Therefore, q is equal to 12 minus 9, that is 3. So, these are the values of p and q that you obtain here. This question can be solved using the factor theorem. Now let's take up another question. It says if fx is x square plus px plus q and gx is equal to x square plus lx plus m and both of them are divisible by x plus a, we have to prove that a is equal to m minus q by l minus p. How do we proceed in this question? Now since it is given that fx and gx are both divisible by x plus a, which means x plus a is a factor of both fx and gx. Now, if x plus a is a factor of both fx and gx, therefore, f of minus a is equal to g of minus a is equal to 0 from factor theorem. That is what the factor theorem was, right? If a polynomial is divisible by a given linear polynomial x plus a, then f of minus a would be 0. So, this is 0. So, what do we get here now? Putting f minus a would be a square minus ap plus q, right? And putting minus a in gx, we have a square minus la plus m and both of them are equal to 0. This is also true. This is equal to 0 and this equal to 0. Therefore, both of them are equal. This equal to 0, this equal to 0. Therefore, f of minus a is equal to g of minus a. We can say that, right? Now, if you take these two equations, a square would cancel out. Take a to one side. So, you have, you bring a this side. So, you get la minus ap and you get m. Q goes to the other side. So, it becomes minus q. A is common here. So, you have L minus P is equal to M minus Q, or A is equal to m minus q by l minus p. This is what you had to prove. So this is how you take up this question. So there are a few more questions in the textbook that you are following, the Eduwiser's Mathematics for Class 9th, and in there you have some more questions related to the factor theorem, remainder theorem, and also related to the algebraic identities, which is the subsequent chapter. Now there are some practice questions given there as well, so you can attempt those. And if you are using the app, Eduwiser's app, there are some tests also available for these chapters. I hope you attempt them and get good marks. Thank you.